Hi there.
What?
What's your name, kid?
Who are you calling, kid? Who the hell are you?
I'm George Stobart, and I'm with the good guys.
You're a head case, mister. A few sandwiches short of the picnic.
Cut the crap and tell me your name.
Liam McGuire.
What are you doing hanging around the bar, McGuire?
I'm on the run from me dad.
Why? Did you do something bad?
I ain't done nothing, boss.
You can tell me, kid. Is it your dad?
Oh, sir. He drinks every last penny down his evil throat. And there's me poor old mother, bedridden and dying of presumption. I tried to buy him medicine. Chop firewood for Father Mahoney till me fingers bled. The old skinflint cheated me too. But I took the pennies he gave me back home. Look, Ma, says I, see what your darling son has earned with his own sweat and blood, when suddenly me dad appears and grabs the loot. I'm off to Dublin heavy drinking, says he. Watch out till I get back. That's why I runned away.
Something in the grin on his face told me he wasn't being strictly truthful. Compared to him, Huckleberry Finn was a candidate for Altar Boy of the Year. Do you know anything about Pegram's Dig?
He wouldn't let me anywhere near it. I offered to help, but he chased me off. I didn't want to see his smelly old hole anyhow.
Did anyone from the village work at the dig?
Pegram brought some students and bums with him. He reckoned no one in Lochmarn would know what to look for. The only local guy who worked for him was Sean Fitzgerald.
Fitzgerald says he's never been anywhere near the dig.
He's having you on, mister.
What can you tell me about the castle, McGuire?
What do you want to know?
Well, can I get inside?
No. It's locked up.
Does anyone live there?
No. Only, what do you want to know? Oh, nothing.
You know something about the castle you're not telling me, don't you?
No.
What is it you're covering up? Is it something you're scared of?
I ain't scared of nothing.
I'll give you one last chance to tell me about the castle.
Oh, yeah? And what if I don't?
Then I'm taking you back to school.
Oh, there's a ghost. It's called the Phantom of Lochmarn.
You're not telling me you believe in ghosts, are you?
Mister, I seen it with me very own eyes. Last Tuesday night, I went up to see what that dig was about. I just reached the top of the wall when I hears this awful noise.
What sort of noise?
A horrible snuffling and snorting, like O'Brien's pig, only worst. It was coming from inside the castle.
Did you find out what was making the noise in the castle?
No fear. I just sat there on the wall like Humpty Dumpty. The moon was cracked and greasy like an old dinner plate. The yard was full of shadows. I could have been hiding anything. I would have gone home, but me legs had lost their stuffing.
Did you get to see the ghost?
Indeed I did. And a fearsome sight it is too. I sat on me arse, waited while the moon went down. Then out it comes from the shadows, all grey and tattered and hunched over like an old bent willow. Then I hears this spluttering and splashing and horrible laughter in the dark. I was so scared. Why, I fell off the bloody wall.
I'm sure there's a rational explanation for what you saw at the castle.
There is. The bloody place is haunted.
Have you seen a guy dressed as a clown?
Here in Lochmarn? They all dress like clowns.
The man I'm looking for is a dangerous psychotic.
Jesus. It's just like that film I saw. There's this clown, see? And he's after this kid who saw him kill a guy. He tries to warn the sheriff, only no one believes him. Then, while he's in the tub, the clown cuts him up with a chainsaw.
My God, that doesn't sound suitable for a kid like you.
Who are you calling a kid? I'm 25.
Yeah, right. You're not a day over 14.
Oh, no, it's 25 that I am. Married with a car and 3 kids. 10 kids if you count the wives.
Do you know a man called Pegram?
Can you describe him like on the telly in the cop shows?
He's an English archaeologist.
I know the man you mean if he's the one.
Can you tell me where I'd find Pegram?
No, I can't, because he's not here now. But if I sees him, I'll ask him.
Do you know what Pegram was doing in the castle?
Digging for buried treasure. Jewels and gold and skeletons, like in the films.
See you later, kid.
Okay, mister.
Mr. Fitzgerald? Doyle told me you definitely worked at the dig. He's seen you there. You might as well admit it.
I knew this would happen. I knew I'd get caught.
I need to talk to Professor Pegram, if he's still alive.
What do you mean? Is he in danger?
Yeah, you too, if I'm right.
You're not from the Social Security.
Hell no. What makes you think that?
Well, I was claiming benefits at the same time I was working for Pegram.
I'm not in a position to make judgments, Sean. That's between you and your conscience. All I want is to talk to Pegram about the gem.
But he's not here!
I know that. But he left that package with you, didn't he? So where did Pegram go?
I don't know. I swear it. He came to see me early this morning. Said he was leaving. He asked me to give this package to a guy called Marquet.
Show me what's in the package, Sean.
I can't do that.
Why not?
I promised the professor.
So what? You didn't have any qualms about your benefit scam. So where's the harm in taking a peek inside Pegram's package?
You don't know these people. I can't. I don't dare.
This is your last chance to show me the package, Fitzgerald. I've been patient with you, but now it's time to kick ass.
But he'll kill me.
Who will?
The man from Paris. Jack Marquet. Pegram told me if I gave him the package, unopened, I'd hear no more about it. But if I double-crossed Marquet, I'd be dead.
I'll deal with Jacques Marquet. Give the package to me.
No. Why should I trust you? I don't know who to trust anymore. I wish I'd never even heard of the Lochmarne gem.
Hey! I just seen a big red...
Get out of here, Maguire. Come back when you're old enough.
What's the lad howling about?
A big red sports car. Sean Fitzgerald's been run over.
Get out! Noisy little tyke.
Maybe you should send out some medicinal brandy maker.
Oh, yes. And who's going to pay for it?
Not me.
Me too, neither.
No! No! Careful!
I was telling the truth about Fitzy, mister.
Okay, okay, calm down. Now tell me what happened.
I was standing here, minding me own business, when I saw this beautiful red sports car coming up over the hill. Would you look at that, says I. And I going over to take a closer look. Next thing, Fitzy comes tearing out of the pub and nearly knocks me on me ass. But the car just flies at him. It was too fast for poor old Fitzy. I hit him an awful wallop. He goes flying up on top. Jesus, says I. I thought he was a goner. Next thing, the driver hops out. And I couldn't believe my eyes.
He was dressed like a bloody pixie.
I pushed the switch down, but in doing so, it snapped off in my hand. Excuse me.
Yes, sir?
I'll try a glass of beer, please.
Is this your first pint of real ale?
Well, I guess so. What's real ale, anyhow?
Beer that's brewed from natural ingredients to traditional methods. It shouldn't be kept under pressure or refrigerated. And finally, it should have a good body and distinctive character.
In other words, it's flat and worn with bits in, and it makes you fall over.
I'm sorry, but the pump appears to be broken.
I could fix it for you.
I don't think so. This is a job for a professional electrician. Oh well, at least the glass washer is still working.
It's not my idea, is it?